sure seem to have it all, fame, money, and all that it can buy. So should stars also have thick skins? Well, a fishbowl life is part of the deal, right? Maybe not. Many big names, including Taylor Swift, are fighting back for a little respect from those making jokes at their expense. Nightline's Juju Chang reports.
I say I hate you, we break up, you call me, I love you. Taylor Swift got rich and famous for penning addictive tunes about love and heartbreak. Crowds cheered at the Grammys when she dished out, "We are never ever getting back together."
Like, ever.
And her real-life whirlwind romances, most recently with a Kennedy grandson, and then with One Direction heartthrob Harry Styles, keep her constantly in the tabloids. But all that soul-bearing may come at a cost. It all started at the Golden Globe Awards, when the queens of comedy, Tina Fey and Amy Poehler, teased Swift about her love life.
You know what, Taylor Swift? You stay away from Michael J. Fox's son.
This week, we discovered Swift didn't take kindly to the joke, responding to it in the new issue of Vanity Fair by referencing a quote she loves. "There's a special place in hell for women who don't help other women." But Hollywood observers say that comedians and their celebrity punchlines are well aware of the rules of engagement.
You're fair game if you go to an award show. They're going to make jokes about you. It's par for the course. It's part of being there.
It can be the price of fame.
You get rewarded greatly. You live a life most people could never dream of. You have enormous riches. You have to learn by that point to brush off criticism. You have to have a very thick skin. You have to have a very thick skin to even make it.
Roasting celebrities has become a signature move at awards shows, like Ricky Gervais, who notoriously skewered the A-listers at last year's Golden Globes.
Many of you probably know him best from such facilities as the Betty Ford Clinic and Los Angeles County Jail. Please welcome Robert Downey Jr.
Gervais told Nightline he makes no apologies.
That wasn't a room full of wounded soldiers. That was a room full of the richest, most privileged people in the world.
Last week at the Oscars, Seth MacFarlane took aim at one of the biggest stars in Hollywood.
To give you an idea just how young she is, it'll be 16 years before she's too old for Clooney.
And the megastar took it in stride. As for Swift's counteroffensive, Poehler couldn't resist a retort. "I feel bad if she was upset. I am a feminist, and she's a young and talented girl. That being said, I do agree I am going to hell. But for other reasons, mostly boring tax stuff." Perhaps the whole mean affair will wind up as fodder for Swift's next number one hit.
Why you gotta be so mean?
For Nightline, I'm Juju Chang in New York.